Hi friends and welcome back. And if you're stopping by for the first time, I'm Arelis and welcome to my happy home. I am so happy that you stopped by today because today is a special video and I'm so excited. I am joining my two beautiful friends, Christy from Inspired Living with Christy and Lou Anne from It's Always Something Around Here. The two ladies have teamed up and invited a few of their friends to join them in this collaboration.
Welcome to My Happy Home, where I bring you DIYs, hauls, home decor, thrifting, and much more on a budget. If you're interested in these types of videos, then please like, comment, and subscribe.
In this collaboration, we are bringing you some ideas and inspiration how you can style thrifted items in your home or maybe do a thrift store makeover for the Christmas season. And in my case, I'm going to do a DIY. I'm going to share with you how I create something for my Christmas decor. And you guys, I am so excited and I cannot wait to see what all the other ladies have come up with because everyone is doing something different. So I am sure that you will be inspired by every video that you see. So make sure that you check out the playlist that is linked below and just be inspired, you guys. It is the most wonderful time of the year and we all love decorating for this season. So without any further ado, let's get started on this DIY project.
Now let me start by showing you this sleigh that I thrifted last year for €1. I did a haul on this as part of a collab video, which was Thriftmas in July. I will leave the link up here if you've missed that. I wanted to do a DIY on it, but I just didn't came around to doing it. Now here are some of the items that I'm going to be using for this project. I have this tartan fabric that I won't be using after all. This old tree skirt that I had for ages and I wasn't using. And this fiber felt or some filling. And this basket was simply perfect for this project. I was looking for something exactly like this. I liked the shape of it and the price, of course, 50 cents. I thought it was perfect for this project. Now, if you haven't guessed it by now, I am going to create Santa's sleigh. I'm starting off by marking the part that I'm going to cut off to try to recreate the shape of Santa's sleigh. I'm using my garden scissors to cut through the basket and it was pretty hard and it took some patience, but eventually I managed it. After cutting the basket, the edges were really sharp, so I'm using a little bit of hot glue to soften up the edge. Now that the edge is nice and soft, I can move on to the next step, and that is covering the basket in the fiber felt. Because of the round shape of the basket, it is easier to glue down the fiber felt in two pieces instead of one. After it's all covered in the fiber felt, it's gonna look something like this. And here I'm just trying to see if I need to thicken up the basket on some parts, but that wasn't necessary. And the next part is to cover the sleigh in the red fabric, and therefore I am using my tree skirt, and I'm using the inside out. Here you see me cutting off the green edge of the tree skirt, and we will be using that later on in this project. Now, if you know me by now, you know I like easy and simple projects. And I think even though that this was quite easy, it did take me quite some time to put it together, and it still was a lot of fun. But I really had to try out a lot before I got it to work the way I wanted to. So for now, this doesn't look really, really all that well, but you're gonna see in the end, it is going to look so, so cute. Now here I'm cutting off the shape of the bottom of the sleigh so that I can use it on the inside. What I really liked about this project is that it really felt to me like making a puzzle. I always had to look for the right pieces to put in the right places. So yeah, that really made it quite challenging, but really so much fun to do. And for the last part, I am using the oval shape to cover the bottom of the sleigh. And I think that this was the most difficult part of the entire project. Because you see me still pulling and tucking and pulling and tucking away to get it the way I wanted to. And this is what it looks like so far. And I think it's really coming together. Now I am using this faux fur on a ribbon that I'm going to be gluing around the rim of the sleigh. And after gluing the faux fur, I think it is really starting to look like Santa's sleigh with the red and the white, but we are not finished yet. I'm using this red jute rope to cover the seams on the inside of the sleigh as well as the outside around the edges of the faux fur. Next, I'm using the rim that I cut off the tree skirt to give it that pop of green. Next, I'm going to make a Santa's toy bag out of this last piece of tree skirt that I have left. It isn't exactly the shape and the size that I want, but I have to work with what I got. Now, here I am making a slight error. I had to turn this inside out before I glue it down, but okay, I will make it work in the end, as you will see later on. To make up for the error that I just made, I am going to glue down this red and white thread all around the edge of the toy bag. Now, this bag has to look like it's full of toys, so I'm going to fill it up with some of the filling. And here I am noticing that I also had to do the inside of the toy bag with this red and white thread. So that's what I'm doing here. To close down the toy bag, I am using a piece of the green rim that I cut off the tree skirt. And to give it that extra festive look and sound, I am gluing down a jingle bell to each end. And here is the end result, and I am so happy with how this turned out. And to be honest, I had this in mind, but I wasn't really sure if I was able to pull it off as well as I did. Anyway, I had so much fun creating this DIY, and I hope that I could have given you some inspiration to create your own Christmas decor from a thrifted item. Well, I hope that you have enjoyed this video. If you did, don't forget to give it a thumbs up and leave me a comment down below. That will really help my channel out a lot. Now, this is a friends collab, so make sure you go over to the playlist and check out my friends' videos as well and leave them a comment and show them some love and support. For now, I want to thank you all so much for watching, and I hope to see you again in my next one really soon. Until then, remember to always live, laugh and love. Happy holidays!